Learning SQL is easy. Practicing it is a bit harder. The reason is simple, there aren't many exercises out there for those who have just started learning SQL online. But that's why I created the Practice SQL video course. If you have just learned the basics of SQL, then this course will help you deepen your knowledge by actually letting you use SQL to solve real tasks. If you have never ever touched SQL before, and want to learn it from scratch via this course, I've got you covered too. At the beginning of every lecture, I will link the appropriate tutorial articles to walk you through the necessary theoretical basics. If you haven't used SQL for a while and want to refresh your knowledge, if you are preparing for a job interview, for example, this course will be a great help in that as well. And I especially recommend this course for students who have started the SQL for Data Analysis article series on Data 36. These tasks are designed to help put into practice everything you learn there. When you enroll in the Practice SQL video course, you will get instant access to a true-to-life dataset, 30+ exciting SQL tasks, and the solution videos with a detailed explanation of each task. If you are here, you have probably already read a few articles on my blog, so you know that I always try to make things as simple, as clear, and as easy to follow as I can, and this course is no exception. Okay, let's take a look at the curriculum. Before everything else, you will have to set up your SQL environment. You will get free access to another shorter video course of mine, where I explain the process step by step. Then we will start easy. The first few tasks are about the very basics of SQL, like how to select tables and columns, or how to filter for specific values. In the next lecture, you will have to form queries with multiple filters, so you can filter for specific subsegments in our dataset. After you have mastered the basics, it will be time to level up. You will get tasks requiring more complex SQL concepts, the SQL functions, like sum, count, or average, and the group by clause. After that, we will target the intermediate level, and you will have to write SQL queries to join different SQL tables. In the next lecture, you will get advanced SQL tasks, where you have to apply subqueries and having clauses too. And eventually, you will get a few final test exercises, where you can combine all the different methods that we have learned and practiced in the previous lectures. A quick note, if you have never heard of some of the things I mentioned here, like subqueries or having clauses or joining tables, don't worry, as I mentioned earlier, I always link the related SQL tutorial articles to the given lectures, so you can quickly fill in the gaps. These 6 lectures comprise more than 30 exercises in total, and the same amount of solution videos. You will get access to all lessons instantly, so you can go through them at your own pace. For beginners, I recommend taking one lecture, so 2 to 5 exercises a day, but more experienced students can finish the course even in one piece. It's totally up to you. By the end of the course, I hope you will agree with what I tell all my students. SQL is easy. The rules you have to learn are simple. The only hard part is when you have to combine these rules. And believe me, in real-life tasks, you have to combine them a lot. But it's like building a house. You just have to prepare and fit all the bricks with special care and you will get a solid structure. The same goes for your SQL skills. If you take the time and the energy to not just learn, but also practice, practice and practice every single principle, these will build up into a rock-solid system and eventually into a powerful skill that you can profit from during your entire career. So is it worth it to practice your SQL skills? Most definitely. And this is what the Practice SQL video course will help you with.